We are starting with the power augmentation system here. Power augmentation. That means name itself suggests power is the thrust. Okay? For a jet engine, power is thrust. Augmentation means increasing. So basically what we are going to do is we are going to understand how we can increase the thrust. Okay, how we are going to increase the thrust. So there are two main methods that we'll have to understand. First one is the water injection. And the second one is the afterburner. Okay, so we'll first understand what is water injection. But before that, let us understand what is the need for the power augmentation system. Okay, we are talking about why we will require a power augmentation. Suppose this is my aeroplane. Okay, this is a fighter aircraft. Okay, let's say this is a fighter aircraft. Okay, it enters the enemy territory. Okay, so if a country is trying to attack an enemy will not sit idle, right? He will also try to target your aircraft and try to damage your aeroplane, right? So let us say that we have got another fighter aircraft behind this, okay, which is trying to target this aircraft. So what this aircraft should do, it should have enough power available to him so that he can run away from here. Understanding? You have power, right? Aeroplane has a power, so it has entered the enemy territory, and the enemy also starts to attack the aircraft because they know that this is going to damage the property of our country. So we want to kill this aircraft. So we will send the fighter aircraft, right? Any enemy country will send the fighter aircraft. Now, if this aircraft cannot run away, what will happen is this will shoot him down, right? So to run away, you should be able to generate power. Okay. Now, when I say power, you will say jet engine is already there. Just move the throttle lever ahead and we'll get that power, right? But if we are putting the jet engine and that is we are moving the throttle lever ahead, we can get us only a limited amount of power, right? That is the maximum power available, whatever is, okay? Whatever is the maximum amount of the power available, we can utilize that entire power over here, okay? But it will still not be sufficient. Why? Because we are at a very high altitude. So when we increase the altitude, what happens is density of the air decreases, pressure of the air decreases. That means mass of the air flowing into the engine also decreases. If mass is decreasing, what is the thrust formula? Thrust is equals to m jet velocity minus inlet velocity, right? So m is the mass. As you go at a higher altitude, because of this problem, density decrease, pressure decrease, mass will decrease. That means in turn your thrust is also decreasing. To overcome this effect, I need to augment my power. Okay, also suppose your runway is smaller. Okay, let us say my runway is smaller and I need to take up from this. So I will again use the power augmentation system. So you need to understand why power augmentation system is required. It is required only in case I'm not getting the maximum power or I want to take off from the shorter runway. Okay, so for doing so, we have got two methods. One is the water injection. Another one is the afterburner. So before we go ahead, let us understand what happens in the range. Okay, let us say this is a jet engine. Okay, it is flying into the range. Okay, we know here we have got a combustion chamber, right? Inside the combustion chamber, we have got three things: fuel plus ignition source. Plus oxygen. When these three things are available, this will burn. Correct? Now what happens? Suppose there is a rainfall. Okay. I have taken violet color for the rainfall. Okay. Suppose there is a rainfall. What will happen is rainwater will enter the engine. Right? This section is completely open. We do not keep anything in the front of the engine, right? So when the aeroplane is going forward and it is raining, what will happen is rainwater will enter the engine. right? What should be my logic? If the rainwater is entering, it might enter the combustion section, which can extinguish the flame. If the ignition source is removed out by putting the water, flame will be switched off. So engine will not be able to generate the power, right? That is what is the normal understanding. If you don't know how the jet engine works, right? But we know what will happen over here. When the aeroplane is going forward and the rainwater is entering, the first section that it comes in contact with after the inlet is the compressor. Compressor, when it is rotating at a very high speed, is trying to compress the air. So when you are compressing something, you will increase the temperature. So the temperature of the air is increasing. Pressure also increases, temperature also increases. If you know the general gas law, if the pressure increases, temperature will also increase. So here there is a high temperature. This high temperature will convert the water into water vapor. That means it will be getting converted into what? Gas, which will not extinguish my flame. Understood? That's why the jet engine, when it flies into the rain, it will not be switched off. Any doubts so far here, Bitter? No?
No, sir.
Okay. So let's go ahead. So what we have understood over here is whenever the aeroplane takes the water intake inside, the water gets converted into the gas and then it enters the combustion section. This is what we have understood so far. Now we know that a water is heavier than the air, right? Water is heavier than air, correct? That means if I convert the water into water vapor, my mass will increase, correct? If we compare, I take two containers. Okay? In this container, I completely fill it with the water till here. In this container, I fill it with the air. And if I weigh both the container, it is 100% sure that the container with the water will weigh more, right? Correct? So if the container with the water is going to weigh more, okay? If the container with the water is going to weigh more, my mass will increase. Look at the formula. Thrust is equals to m vj minus va. That means what? If the mass increases, thrust increases. If the mass increases, thrust increases. That means when the aeroplane is going into the rain, it is advantage to the pilot. Understood? When the aeroplane flies into the rain, it is not a disadvantage. It's in fact an advantage for the pilot, because what happens? Mass of the air is increasing, which in turn is increasing the thrust.
Okay. So one doubt, sir.
Yeah, better.
So what about centrifugal compressor, sir? So they are only single centrifugal compressor.
Yeah, better. But in centrifugal compressor, my compression ratio is 6 or 7:1. That means if I take this much amount of the air, let us say, if I can keep this area into 60 centimeter cube volume, it will get converted into just 10 centimeter cube volume. That means you are compressing it so much. And I just told you, if you compress anything, pressure and temperature is going to increase. Okay. In your axial flow compressor, what was happening? At every stage, it was just 1:1 pressure rise. Right? Here, I get a sudden rise in the pressure. That means I will get a sudden rise in temperature also, right? So, even if there is just one stage of the centrifugal compressor, it will get converted into gas. Most of our helicopter engines, no? Since they have a small space, they cannot have axial flow compressor engine. Their engine has to be smaller. So most of the helicopter engines, they have a centrifugal compressor. But we have seen that helicopter flies in the rain. Understood? So what you need to understand is when the air is passing through the jet engine, because of the rise in the pressure, it will get converted into gas. We are not passing the water into the combustion chamber. If I pass water in the combustion chamber, only then the flame will be extinguished. Otherwise, flame is not extinguished. Okay? If you send water vapor, it will not extinguish. Okay. So the first part is it increases the mass. second important thing about water going inside, rainwater going inside, is that water will be cooler than the air, right? Compared to the dry air, the temperature of the water will be less. So if I have a water vapor entering over here, whose temperature is less, I can add more fuel. Correct? More fuel means more thrust. Understood here? More fuel means more thrust. So let us understand now the water injection. It's the same thing, whatever we have understood. Instead of rain. Now see, rain is a natural phenomenon. Okay, if I want to take off from a runway, if there is a rainfall, it's good for me. Okay, rain is coming. But if there is no rainfall and I still want to increase my thrust, so what I can do is I can have a water injection system. In the water injection system, what happens is, this is the jet engine, right? At the end of the inlet, or we can say at the beginning of the compressor. Okay, at the end of the inlet, or we can say at the beginning of the compressor, there are small tubes coming which are open over here. Okay, from which water will be thrown in front of the compressor at a very high speed. Okay, and then this water will enter and it will act same like your rainfall. Okay, everything after this, whatever I've taught you for the rainfall, same thing will happen. Water will go inside the compressor. Compressor is rotating at a high speed. So the compressor will increase the pressure. If the pressure increases, according to the general gas law, pressure is directly proportional to the temperature. That means temperature of the air also increases. So high temperature will convert this water into water vapor. Then this water vapor will get into the combustion chamber. Since it's a low temperature as well as more mass of the air, I can add more amount of the fuel. More amount of the fuel will give rise to the more thrust. Understood water injection? This water which is added can be added at two places. Please remember, water can be added at two places. First one is at the inlet of compressor. So what I'm doing here is I'm adding the water at the inlet of the compressor. Second one is at the inlet of diffuser. I can eliminate, I cannot, if I want, I can not add the water into the compressor, but add it at the inlet of the diffuser. Okay, same effect. High temperature air which is coming over here, along with the water, when it enters the diffuser, diffuser has got a divergent section, pressure increases, temperature increases, mass increases. Okay, but how will the manufacturer decide that which one is the advantage? What are advantages? Both will increase the thrust. But what method should be used? See, they say that when we use the water at the compressor inlet, at least the first stage or the second stage compressor, it will come directly in contact with the water. Right? This is a rotating part. It is coming directly in contact with the water. So what can happen is it can lead to the corrosion. Understood? The first and second stage of the compressor comes in direct contact with the water, because here the water will not get converted into water vapor. Here the water will stay in the water stage only, the water state only. So when it passes to first, second, third, at least in three stages when it goes, then it starts getting converted into the steam. But before that, it is still water. So if it is a water, if the water comes in contact with the metal, we know corrosion can start. Right, so there is this problem that corrosion may arise. Okay, to overcome this problem, what some of the manufacturers say, that instead of putting the water over here, we'll put the water in the diffuser. Understood? Secondly, what they decided is, you know, why to use only water? We can use a mixture of water plus methanol. Methanol is basically the alcohol category 1C, means one carbon alcohol. Okay, so instead of using the water, we will use a mixture of water and methanol. Okay, methanol is the alcohol. Okay, the people that they drink the alcohol, that is ethanol. The one which can be drunk is ethanol. But what I'm talking about ethanol. Okay, so methanol cannot be drank. if someone drinks this, he will die on the spot, beta. It's very, very poisonous. So what we do is we take a mixture of water and methanol. And we'll do the same thing. We'll add it either at the inlet of the compressor or at the inlet of the diffuser. Effect will be same. Mass of the air increases because there is a water. Okay. And the temperature decreases. Okay. What is the advantage of adding methanol? That should be the question, right? What I said so far is that it's the same thing. But what is the advantage of adding methanol? Methanol acts like a fuel. Understood? Methanol itself acts like a fuel. So instead of using your main fuel, we are adding methanol as a fuel. Correct, beta? Have you understood this? But there is a disadvantage of adding methanol. What is the disadvantage? Firstly, if I add it at the inlet of the compressor, methanol will get converted into vapors here itself. Okay. Even if I add it at the inlet of the diffuser, it will get converted into vapor. But that will not be a problem because combustion chamber is just behind this. But if I add it in the inlet of the compressor, in the compressor itself, methanol gets converted into the vapor. Okay. That is one of the disadvantages. Second disadvantage is the calorific value. What is calorific value? Piston engine, you must have done, no? Where the teacher must have taught you what is 100 LL fuel, what is 120 LL fuel, what is 150 LL fuel. Have they taught you better? Yes or no, beta? Have they taught you what is calorific value? Am I audible? Am I audible, beta?
Yes, sir. So they have taught.
They have taught, no? So you know what is calorific value. Calorific value means when you heat something, what is the amount of heat energy that we get? It's called as a calorific value. For different types of fuel, the calorific value is different. So when I talk methanol, in jet engine, we use kerosene, right? In jet engine, we use the fuel which is a kerosene type. So when methanol and kerosene are taken into consideration, calorific value of methanol is very, very less than the kerosene. So basically, instead of adding methanol, if I added kerosene, that would be better for me. Understood? But you need to know that water along with the methanol is added. This type of combination is being used in many fighter aircraft. Okay. Now let us understand what is the disadvantage of water injection system. First disadvantage of water injection system is you need to carry a water tank. Right? I am saying you need to put the water, but you need to carry the water, then only you will put the water in the inlet, right? So first thing is you need to carry the water. Second thing is a water tank. Second thing is you will require a system. System means what? Pipeline will be required. Okay, valves will be required, pressure generator will be required, pump will be required to pressurize it and throw it over here, right? So the system will be required, right, along with the tank. This two will increase the weight of the aeroplane, right? This two will increase the weight of the aeroplane. So if the weight of the aircraft increases, what will happen? Entire aviation from the first semester onwards, we are learning that we should try to reduce the weight of the aeroplane. But here what is happening because of all this thing, weight is increasing. So if the weight of the component increases, takeoff weight decreases. That means you will need to carry less amount of passenger. Okay. If this is a fighter aircraft, you'll need to carry one less missile. Okay. And the fighter pilots, they know what is the what can happen with one less missile. Okay, it can be a matter of life and death. So this is the disadvantage of water injection system. Another favorite question of the DGCA is how much will be the thrust increase in the water injection system? So it is 10 to 30% rise in the thrust. How much is the thrust increase? 10 to 30% is the rise in the thrust. So in this, why methanol is not used is a DGCA question. Okay. Where do we add the water is a DGCA question. both places it can be added. If they ask what is which place is the advantage, there is no such place which is an advantage. Both of them have the same effect. Okay. They will ask why methanol is used. So you will say methanol is used to act as a fuel. What is the disadvantage of using a methanol? Methanol has a less calorific value than the kerosene. How much is the thrust increase of the water injection method? 10 to 30%. This will be twisted in the exam and they will say after using the water injection, the thrust provided by the engine is 110% to 130%. Both of them are correct. Here he will say how much is the increase. Here he will say what is the new thrust. So new thrust is 130% of the original thrust.
Sir, the 110% of that rise is of only water or water and methanol?
Both, water and methanol. See, if you use water and methanol, then it will go into this range. Depending upon where you put the water, how much water you put, the thrust value will differ. Okay. Also, depending upon how much methanol is added in the water, this thrust value differs. But general increase is 10 to 30%.
And sir, it is greater at diffuser or compressor, sir? The thrust.
It will not matter. Because ultimately, both of them are going to get converted into gas before they enter the combustion chamber. Okay. Only thing is, if we add it in front of the compressor, your first and second stage will be prone to corrosion. Okay, so there corrosion can happen. To avoid that, we need to add it in the diffuser. Okay, but it's not necessary. All the manufacturer, you will see that they add it in the compressor only, because if the aeroplane is going to fly in the rain, there is no way I can say that this water is going to corrode the aircraft, right? Because rainwater will come in from the front only, no? So depending upon the design, if it is very complicated to put a pipe over here, they will put a pipe over here. Okay. When you go into this field, no, you will come across task. Okay. You will come across a task. This task mostly happens in Mumbai or any coastal area. Okay. Any coastal area where the aeroplane is flying, this task has to be carried out every 7 days. Okay. The task is called as the compressor cleaning. Okay. Compressor cleaning. The main reason for compressor cleaning is in the coastal area generally is because we are in the area where there is a lot of saline water, right? Sea is there. So there is a lot of saline water. And if the aeroplane is flying into this area, the humid air will also consist of saline water and will enter the engine. Okay. So what you need to do is you need to clean the compressor. So let us say this is the compressor. So what you will do is you will take a pipe. Okay. You will take a hose basically. And from the hose, you will dry run the aircraft engine. And from the hose, you will throw the water over here. It is same effect created as the water injection. Any doubt here?
No, sir.
No? See, what is the cleaning of compressor in the coastal areas? No, coastal areas like means the area which are on the which are the sea, okay, which are basically are near the sea facing, okay. So like Mumbai, then we can say Kerala. These are all around them. There is a sea. So wherever there is a sea, this aeroplane when they fly, what happens is this saline water comes in contact with the material of the blade. Okay. And if the salt is available, it will lead to the corrosion of the blades. So what you need to do is when the aeroplane lands every 7 days, okay, after every 7 days, you need to clean the compressor. Okay. You need to clean the compressor. Okay, beta. And to clean the compressor, what we do is we put the water from the front. That is, I will take the hose over here. Okay, you will require two people. Okay, generally the person who is at a lower level, let us say who is a technician or who is an apprentice in the organization, he will keep this hose over here. Whereas the engineer will sit inside the cockpit. He will start the engine without fuel. Fuel and ignition will not be switched on. Only water, only dry running. Dry running means only the starter is connected and the starter will start rotating the compressor. Through this hose, you put the water over here. this water will clean the compressor. Okay, in some cases, if a deep cleaning is required, we will also put a soap water. So first layer will be water, then soap water, then again the water. Okay, beta. Chalo. Any doubt in this water injection mechanism?
Filled no, cleaning. Sir.
This is also called as filter cleaning, one of the important tasks in the field. Let us understand afterburner. Name itself is suggesting. Afterburner means it is burning after something, right? Afterburner. Also called as reheating. Afterburner is also called as the reheating. Ek second, beta. Yeah, beta. So see, reheating means what? Now let us understand how the jet engine works. You already know, but just go through it first. Okay. Compressor, diffuser, combustion chamber. Then there is a turbine, and then there is the exhaust port. So this is the exhaust area, right? Now, what happens is, when we take the air from the front, it has got the oxygen, right? As I told you, to burn something, you require three things. First one is the oxygen, okay? Secondly, you require a fuel, and third one is the ignition source. So the igniter plug is doing the work of the ignition source. We are adding the fuel and the oxygen is taken from the okay, and the oxygen is taken from the front of the compressor. Okay, so when this three combines over here, the combustion of the gases take place. Okay, let us say this is a flame. Okay, and let us say that this is the flame. Okay, this may be the flame. Okay, beta. Now what happens, see, as the air is coming out, there is still, see, when you do the combustion, there is still some amount of an air which has the uncombined oxygen, or I can say unutilized oxygen. Understanding what I'm trying to say? That when you are burning the air and fuel mixture over here, some of the air will still have the oxygen which has not been utilized. Okay, this oxygen still has got enough energy so that if I add a fuel into it and burn it, it can still do the same effect of this. So what we generally do, we will take the see, this is what happens. Exhaust gas comes up. Okay, here what we will do is we will add another section over here. Okay, in this section we will add fuel. In this section, we will add fuel. Air, exhaust gases are coming from here, right? Fuel is here. Exhaust gases have oxygen. And we will give a burner, or I can say igniter plug, okay? We'll call here it as a pilot burner. It's a DGCA question. That's why I've used the word pilot burner. You can simply say as the igniter plug, okay? It is available over here. This burns this air and fuel mixture. As this will burn, flames will come out, giving you more amount of the thrust. Understood? Since the combustion is happening after the engine section, it is called as afterburner. Since we are using the same air for heating, it is called as reheating. Both the name are technically correct. You can write afterburners or you can write reheating. But reheating is basically heating the air. Afterburner is called for the entire arrangement. Done, beta. Now let us understand what happens in the afterburner. Here we are adding fuel. We have got a uncombined oxygen. And to burn this, we require the igniter plug. This igniter plug are of different category. We'll understand only the pilot burner. What the pilot burner will do is, we will put a fuel here in the pilot burner. Inside the pilot burner, we are directly putting the fuel. We are putting the fire source over here. This will burn and produce a small flame, and this flame will ignite the remaining mixture. Understood? Secondly, I can have a spark igniter. Spark igniter is basically like the same igniter plug only. Okay, generally an igniter plug which will produce a spark and which will burn. Basically, spark igniter it is called because it's like a spark plug of a piston engine. And thirdly, what we can have is in one of the, see, combustion chamber is here. In one of the combustion section, I can add more amount of a fuel. Okay, what we will do is in one of the combustion section, we will add more amount of the fuel. So what happens is the gases coming out of here will already have a very high temperature. When this high temperature gases comes in contact with the fuel and oxygen, it will burn. Understood what happens over here? In one of the combustion section, we add more amount of the fuel. That will have a high temperature when it comes into the afterburner burner. It starts heating. Okay. Now let us understand this afterburner section. Since there is a, see, if you increase the temperature, just remember this in a jet engine. If you increase the temperature of an exhaust gases, higher the temperature, higher is the thrust. Okay, because they will run at a higher, if there is a high temperature, that means it will have a pressure which can be converted into the velocity. Okay, but because of this turbine, okay, turbine material cannot withstand a temperature greater than 1800 degrees Fahrenheit. Okay, so what I need to do is the gases which are coming out from here, I need to maintain a temperature which is less than or approximately equal to 1800 degrees Fahrenheit. So this is a limitation put on us. But look at afterburner. Is there any turbine at the end? There is no turbine. So I need not to bother about this temperature rise. Okay? You need not to bother about the temperature rise. Just increase the amount of the fuel. Okay? Let the gases show the flame. If you have seen videos of the of this thing, afterburner, you will see that you can clearly see the flame at the back of the engine. Okay, if you have not seen it, you can see it in my own YouTube video better. I have put the YouTube video for this afterburner explaining everything. There you can understand what is happening. Okay, pura proper video hai. So here you can see there is a flame behind us. Okay, so this is what is afterburner. Thrust increased by the afterburner is 50%. Hence, most of your fighter aircraft, instead of using the water injection mechanism, uses afterburner. If you are using the afterburner, you require a variable exhaust nozzle. This is a very important point. Did you see a question? If there is an afterburner, you will always require the variable exhaust nozzle. When afterburner is not in the operation, that means when you are not using afterburner, that time the variable exhaust nozzle is in the closed position. When you are using the afterburner, the variable exhaust nozzle will be in open position, that is, it will be divergent section. Understanding it? So how does the variable exhaust nozzle work? If you are not using the afterburner, you will have a convergent shape. If you are using the afterburner, you will have a divergent shape. This is important because here there will be a lot of high temperature, right? It will try to go in all the direction. Okay. If I close this, it will try to go on this side. I don't want that. Hence, I need to open my exhaust. Hence, we go with the divergent section. The last thing that you need to understand about the afterburner is it has got two modes of operation. One is the hot mode. Another one is the cold mode. Name itself suggests. Hot mode is when afterburner is switched on. That means I am burning the air and fuel over here. Cold mode is when afterburner is not switched on. For example, let us say Indian fighter aircraft goes into the enemy territory and destroys the enemy target. Okay. When they come back into the Indian territory, will they still require to run? No, because even if the enemy aircraft tries to come inside the Indian territory, we have got a rocket launcher in India which we can launch and hit the target, right? So when he's running, when he's coming over the Indian airspace, what the aeroplane will do is it will try to conserve the fuel so that it can reach the destination airport. Okay, in this case you obviously require more amount of fuel, right? So you have already hit the target and you are coming back. That means the aircraft will have less amount of fuel, so it doesn't make any sense it running the hot mode. So what they do is that time they run into the cold mode. So when you are running into the cold mode, this is just a pipe. It is nothing but just a pipe through which the gases are passed. Okay. Any doubt in afterburner, beta? I have covered everything in the afterburner. Do you have any doubt in afterburners?
Sir, it is the same fuel, no, sir?
Yeah, same fuel. Whatever is in the whatever you are using in the combustion chamber, no, same type of the fuel can be used. So you don't require to carry separate fuel.
And sir, that is also at the mileage.
I couldn't hear you, beta. What are you saying?
Sir, fuel.
Disturbance, beta. I couldn't hear you. Please say again, no?
Hello, sir.
Yeah, beta, tell me, no?
Hello. Sir, even this,
after that, I cannot hear anything, beta.
Sir, even this fuel is atomized.
Yeah, but atomized. Because when I'm putting the fuel over here, no, it is basically a fuel nozzle here. When I say I'm putting the fuel, that means I'm putting it with the fuel nozzle. Okay. Please remember this thing, that fuel will not catch a fire until it is in the atomized state. So you need to convert it into atomized state. Okay. There are also a flame holder. One of the DGC questions is asked about this. What this flame holder will do is, when you start the flame will try to go out, right? So initially it will try to keep the flame inside. That is what is the work of the flame holder. Okay, the name itself suggests, if you have not heard about this and you directly go and see in the exam also, no, then also you will understand. Any doubts here?
No, sir.
No? That completes your first part of this section, beta. Power augmentation is finished. Okay. So we understood what is water injection, how the water entering will increase my thrust, what is the afterburner, how the afterburner comes into the picture. Everything is important, beta. If you haven't understood, let me know. Otherwise, what you can do is you can go and watch the videos also, beta. I've already put it in my channel. I don't know who all watches. Okay, there are only few students who watch the channel and still tell me and ask me doubt even before the class starts. Okay, so this, both the topics were already covered in that video. So if you have seen that video, you would have understood this class more nicely. Any other doubt? Can I erase this entire thing? But no doubt, right?
No, sir.
Okay, just give me a minute. I will mark your attendance.
Sir.
Yeah, beta.
Sir, instead of water, can we put liquidized oxygen?
Liquidized oxygen, no, beta. See, the main reason why we are using water is to lower the temperature and increase the mass. If you put a liquidized oxygen, it will become a rocket, no?
Okay, sir.
Another thing is, liquid oxygen is a cryogenic liquid, beta. Cryogenic liquid means, to convert it into a liquid state, you require to reduce the temperature to a very low value. Okay. I believe there is -273 is the boiling point of water. So you need to reduce the temperature to -273. Okay. So not 273, 173. Okay. Just confirm the temperature value. So you need to reduce the temperature to such a low level. So to carry the such a low level temperature, no, you require a special container in which you can carry. That special container is made up of divan. Okay. It is a double lining section in which here there is a vacuum, so that your liquid oxygen can remain in the liquid state. Clear, beta? And this is very, very expensive. Hence, okay, we cannot sir. Afford it in this civil aviation. Fighter side, what happens is there cost is not a, not taken into the picture. Okay, cost of maintaining the aeroplane is not taken into the picture. So fighter side they can use DVAR. Okay, now understand this oxygen bit and liquid oxygen. It is at such a low value. No? If it suppose some it fall one drop of this falls on a palm. Okay, let us say it falls on a hand. It will make a hole in the hand. Okay. I believe we had a teacher from Air India, sorry, Air Force. Okay, we had one teacher from the Air Force. His colleague was working on the liquid oxygen. Okay, here I am teaching you liquid oxygen, how it is carried. But in that aircraft, liquid oxygen was carried to convert it to gaseous oxygen so that the pilot can breathe at a higher altitude. Okay, it was an oxygen system. So they filled it, charged it with the liquid oxygen. But while charging, what happened is, you know, the nozzle over here, suddenly there was a crack and the liquid oxygen came and fell on his hand. So it was a really bad situation. His entire hand burned. Okay. This is called as a cold burn. Okay. Cold burn means what? When a low temperature comes in contact with our body, you know, it will burn. Okay. Very low temperature. See, very low temperature when it comes in contact with the body, you know, that low temperature will try to take the heat away from your body. So when it comes in contact with the skin, it will take all the heat away from the skin and damage your skin. Some cases it can even make the hole inside the skin.